The Infant Car Seat Tolerance Screening by Kathryn Gustafson.
Hello, my name is Kathryn Gustafson, and today I'm going to demonstrate the Infant Car Seat Tolerance Screening, formerly known as the Infant Car Seat Challenge. The Car Seat Tolerance Screen assesses infants less than 6 months of age for their ability to safely travel in a car seat for a recommended length of time. You will first need to establish the need for a car seat tolerance screen with your healthcare team. Criteria may differ across institutions based on their interpretation of the American Academy of Pediatrics recommendations. Algorithms to identify which infants meet criteria in your institution, such as the one shown here, are helpful. Car seat screening should be performed as close to discharge as possible. Infants should be deemed ready for discharge, including the resolution of breathing instability. Infants who required evaluation for apnea, bradycardia, and desaturation events should no longer be under evaluation for breathing instability. Infants who are being treated with oxygen should be on a steady dose with no further changes in the dose planned prior to discharge.
Car seat tolerance screening.
Obtain an order from the prescriber to conduct the 90-minute car seat tolerance screen. The provider conducting the screen should review their institution's policy and procedure. Educate the parents about the car seat tolerance screen. Obtain the car seat that the infant will use from his or her parents. Talk with the parents about the seat's history and establish that the car seat has not been involved in a crash. The provider then performs a pre-screen check whereby he or she inspects the car seat. Inspect the car seat for cracks that may have resulted from a crash, as they may impact the integrity of the car seat. Check the harness straps to ensure they are not stretched or frayed in appearance. If any defects are noted, the seat should not be used and an alternative seat should be obtained. Next, check the label on the seat to ensure that it is a car seat. Some infant seats closely resemble car seats but are not designed to be used as a motor vehicle restraint. Check the car seat for the expiration date to ensure that it has not expired. Do not use an expired seat. Check the height and weight limits on the seat. Height and weight limits may vary, therefore ensure that the seat is appropriate for the infant. Rear-facing car seats are used for small infants. Do not place premature or small infants in a convertible seat.
Car seat tolerance procedure.
Place the infant on a cardiorespiratory and pulse oximeter monitor if it's not already part of the infant's routine care. Ideally, monitor the infant in their crib to establish baseline cardiorespiratory stability. Feed and change the infant's diaper prior to the screen. Dress the infant with a single layer of clothing under the straps. Bulky clothing is not recommended as it could compress during a crash, resulting in ejection of the infant. Shoulder straps should be positioned in the slots at or below the shoulders and the harness clip at armpit level. Obtain baseline vital signs and pulse oximeter reading prior to placing the infant in the car seat. Position the infant in the car seat at a 30 to 45 degree angle per manufacturer's instructions, as a greater than 45 degree angle could cause the infant's head to fall forward and obstruct the airway. Tighten the harness straps until you cannot pinch any slack between your fingers when testing the harness straps over the infant's shoulders. If a gap is present between the infant and buckle, use a crotch roll made with tightly rolled face cloths or similar sized cloth to prevent the infant from sliding down in his or her seat. If there are gaps between the infant and the side of the car seat, or the infant leads to one side, place a roll blanket along the lateral aspect of the infant from their head to their thigh. This will keep the infant positioned midline in the car seat. Do not utilize aftermarket head rolls or positioners. Document how the infant is positioned for the screen, including the use of rolls. Observe for apnea, bradycardia, and oxygen desaturation using recommended parameters. Monitor the infant for 90 minutes to establish cardiorespiratory stability while positioned in the car seat. Infants that pass the screen complete a 90-minute observation with no evidence of apnea, bradycardia, or desaturation events per the recommended criteria. Vital signs and a pulse oximeter reading are obtained and recorded prior to removal from the car seat. Remove infant from the car seat following completion of the screen. The healthcare team discusses and recommends the safest method of transportation for infants who experience difficulties in the car seat. They may advise the infant undergo a repeat screen in a car bed, delaying discharge with implementation of further clinical testing, use of a cardiorespiratory oxygen saturation monitor, and/or supplemental oxygen may be recommended for transportation. If the infant did not meet the criteria to pass, rescreening in a car bed may be a feasible option. Car bed screening is carried out using the same procedures as a car seat tolerance screen described in this video. However, blanket rolls are not used for positioning the infant in a car bed. Discharging an infant home in a car bed often requires additional parental support and education by providers with specialized knowledge and training. Infants discharged in a car bed are recommended for a one-month follow-up car seat screen to facilitate safe transition to a traditional car seat.
Point of clarification. Advise the parents to check with the primary medical doctor in their area to find out if there's a follow-up clinic near them. Documentation.
Providers conducting a screen should document the car seat tolerance screen per the institution's policy and procedure. This typically includes baseline vital signs and pulse oximeter readings prior to placing the infant in a car seat and at the completion of the screen, patient tolerance of the car seat tolerance screen, and outcomes, passed or not. Discharge teaching provided an observation of parent competency. Parents need to show that they can replicate the exact position of the infant during the screen, including the placement of rolls.
Education.
Recommend that parents have the car seat base installed by a certified child passenger safety technician. Many cities and towns offer installations by appointment through the fire or police department. If your institution has an injury prevention car seat program, assist parents in making an appointment for installation. Notify parents at the time of hospital discharge. They will be responsible for securing their infant in the car seat and securing the car seat in the car. Instruct the parents to mail in the registration card. This will ensure they are notified if the car seat is recalled. Check that the parent has access to the car seat instructions. Instructions are often located in a compartment on the car seat. If the instructions are missing, assist the parents to print instructions that are available online. Encourage the parents to keep the instructions with the car seat at all times. Institution-based educational materials should be developed according to the American Academy of Pediatrics recommendations. Check with your institutional policies and procedures regarding standard instructions for parents upon discharge. Review with parents that passing a car seat tolerance screen does not guarantee that their infant will not experience a problem in the future. Reiterate the appropriate positioning and restraint of the infant in the car seat. Provide the parents with the correct written instructions and materials. Written education materials to review with parents may include guidelines for using car seats safely, a copy of the American Academy of Pediatrics car seat checkup, and travel instructions for at-risk populations such as traveling with a baby with special healthcare needs. Additional parent education should focus on related concerns such as keeping the infant warm during cold weather. This can be accomplished by placing blankets over the harness straps. Car seat carrier covers are commercially available. Approved covers fit over the car seat but never under the infant. Infants traveling in their car seats are positioned in the back seat facing the rear of the car. During travel, the infant should be supervised by an adult passenger who is traveling in the back seat with the infant. Thank you for watching this video on the infant car seat tolerance screen.